Health Connection, medical assistance for all.
Hi, this is Dr. Rakesh Jain. I am a pediatric neurologist in Fortis Hospital, and this is my private clinic. I have done my pediatric neurology training primarily from UK. I was consultant in Oxford Teaching Hospital before I came to India about 5 years ago. Today I am going to share some knowledge about autism. Autism is very common all over the world, and I was surprised to see autism in India as well. We do see a lot of children. In the last 5 years, I would have seen more than 500 children of autism. So what happens in autism? Children usually have delayed speech. In normal scenario, a child should be able to utter a single meaningful word by 1 year of age. But in autism, it can take time. Some children, they don't even speak. So they may start speaking at 2 years, 3 years. In addition to that, there is poor interaction with the peer group. They don't have proper eye contact. They cannot play with the peer group. They would like to play on their own. They have some restricted interest like spinning, listening to proper music, or a particular advertisement they would like to. So you can easily find out. In addition to that, there are some stereotypic moments, like when they are excited, they will do hand flapping, something like that. They would make some different postures. They may be scared of some high sounds like whistle of pressure cooker. The noise of mixture would upset them. They would not want to go to the crowded places. So it becomes really difficult for the parents to take their child to the public places, to the family functions, restaurant, and the life becomes really miserable for those parents. So what do we do? It's a big issue nowadays. It's an issue of schooling, issue of taking care of these children at home. There is no proper infrastructure. In Delhi NCR, there are some centers who provides therapy for these children, but it is really a vacuum and a different area to address. So what should we do? First of all, early identification is extremely important to be able to do something about these children. So if we identify these children at the onset, then yes, there are early intervention therapies like occupational therapy, speech therapy, sensory integration, and there are some medicine as well, depending upon if we find out the cause, which is not common in these patients. If we try very hard, in up to 20% of cases, we may be able to find out the cause of autism. In some of them, we may be able to do something, in others, we may not. So, bottom line is, there is no permanent cure for autism. This is a condition, this is a disorder, where if we approach the child by a multidisciplinary team, including a doctor and other therapies, as I named, we can achieve optimum control. And many of these children, they may be able to live a relatively normal life, but it is difficult to predict altogether because things are different, and autism is not a one diagnosis, it's a spectrum. So the child could be on mild spectrum. If we provide appropriate therapy to that child should be able to lead a normal life, while the child on the severe autistic spectrum may have some problem with the cognition, like his intelligence, memory, learning difficulties. So those are the children. With the therapies, they can manage to do things on their own, but we cannot expect too much. But again, I would like to emphasize on this thing. Every child is different, unique, and we should provide the maximum opportunity for every single child to maximize their potential. Rather than labeling them autistic, or sometimes I do get referral that this child has MR, that is mental retardation, and nothing can be done about it, which is absolutely wrong. If we work hard with the families, with these children, with the therapies, then yes, we can achieve certain goals. Thank you very much.
Medical disclaimer: the information in this video is not intended or implied to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. All content, including text, graphics, images, and information, contained on or available through this video is for general information purposes only. It is not intended as medical advice, and should not be relied upon as a substitute for consultations with qualified health professionals who are familiar with your individual medical needs. The whole sole purpose of this video is to make people aware of healthcare and medical knowledge and developments. We at Health Connection specially recommend you to visit an authorized physician nearby for medical opinion, medication, treatments, or procedures. For more details, kindly visit our website, www.healthconnection.in, or if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please do not hesitate to write to us at info@healthconnection.in.